The building is on 16th Avenue, right next to Peter's Drive-In, and it was originally the Rocky View building. But the City of Calgary took over the building, and it served a lot of different purposes over the years. The mural was put on, it was commissioned by Rocky View, and it was put on probably in the very early 1960s. In the plans to widen 16th Avenue, because it is the Trans-Canada, that building was slated as one that needed to come down to be able to widen the street. People who work for the city started asking each other, what's going to happen to this mural when the building comes down? The mural was worth saving for a lot of different reasons. One of them was that it's probably the first mural that was made in Calgary, so it has a lot of historical significance. We faced a lot of challenges. The first one was that the mural itself is actually attached directly onto the cinder block wall of the building. It's a two-story building. In the middle of that wall, there was actually a steel post that supported the second floor of the building. So we had to remove the whole wall in order to keep the mural. Within the city, we had engineers, we had people who work with corporate properties, and then we also were able to subcontract, and they worked so well together that they were able to come up with very innovative solutions. The wall that the mural is on, that actually they become one, the mural and the wall are one thing, it's a supporting wall for the second story of the building. And so they needed to cut out all the parts around the bit of wall that had the mural and separate it from the parts of the building that held the building up. And they actually had to put another supporting beam behind the mural that would keep the whole building standing while they took the mural out. To save the mural, we couldn't take off bits of ceramic, we had to lift the whole thing. Initially, we didn't know how much the mural might weigh because we didn't know when you added all the weights, the wall, the steel, the ceramic. Our guess originally was 8,000 pounds. It turned out it was 17,000 pounds. And it's 16 feet wide and a little more than 10 feet high. Once we determined that it was feasible to save the mural, we started to look for a good location in the same neighborhood, in Ward 7, and close by, because the mural we knew was very, very fragile because of this dry concrete and the ceramic tiles that were set into it. We didn't know how secure those were. We wanted to move it as short a distance as possible. And when we looked around, North Mount Pleasant Art Center is very close, so that fit that requirement. It also has a strong ceramic department, and a lot of the people in the ceramic department actually worked with Drahanchuk at one point or know him. And that seemed to be a natural fit because there would be ambassadors who would understand this mural and be able to present it to other people. We would stay within the ward, so it would still be a historic cultural object that stays within the geographic area in Calgary. So a stand had to be built out of steel that could support that, but that also would fit in with the surrounding of the building. The architect who worked on the historical renovations of North Mount Pleasant a few years ago was also the architect who was able to work on designing a presentation stand for the mural so that they fit together. We're really pleased with this location because it's right on 4th Street. It's a well-trafficked street, it's a bus route. It would be good for people to be able to see the mural from far away and also to be able to come up and enjoy it. It'll be lit at night and there'll be some signage there for people who come closer and they can learn a little more about the mural. Here in Calgary, he did a lot of murals, and this is probably the very first one that he ever made. The mural is not just made out of ceramic, but Drahanchuk cleverly used cement and concrete to hold the mural together and also to be important within the mural. It's the background, the sky, and some of the texture comes from that part of the mural that's not ceramic, but that's cement. Ed Drahanchuk named this mural Alberta Foothills Morning. And in this mural, you'll see many of the things that we are proud of, we who live here. And you'll see the mountains, you'll see both sun and rain, you'll see wheat fields, you'll see oil derricks, you'll see cattle. But one of the things I like the best about this mural is if you go up close, right under where the cattle are standing, you'll see there's the field that they've been standing in, like the back 40. And in there, you'll see hoof prints. If you look a little closer, you'll see a cowboy boot print, and that's the artist's boot print. He's got such a great sense of humor. And at that time, in the 60s and 70s, he was winning awards for his ceramics, and he was doing work across the country. He moved to Quadra Island a few years ago, where he now paints. He will be able to come back, I hope, to see this mural. He's told us a few times he is very pleased with what we've done here at the City of Calgary. He was surprised that it was even possible, and he hopes he'll be able to come and see it. In the spirit of celebrating what Alberta could be, and so the idea for what Alberta could be in the 1960s was really optimistic. It was probably the first mural that was made in Calgary for the outdoors that's made out of ceramics. Ed Drahanchuk, who made it, can't remember exactly what year. He knows that he made it before he moved to Bragg Creek, and he knows he moved to Bragg Creek in the mid-1960s. A lot of people within the city worked together to make this happen, from various departments, the public art program, the department that's called Transportation Infrastructure, and the department called Corporate Properties. And there were people in each of those departments who stepped forward and said, I can help with this, and they worked together.